जननीं शारदां देवीं रामकृष्णं जगद्गुरुं पादपद्मे तयोश्रित्वा प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहुः। One letter a few years back came. A nun joined the monastery. She had gone for studies, got a job there, came in contact with the mission, and then finally joined. In West, we have both monastery and convent attached in many of the places. Hollywood, San Francisco and all. Just like we have in our ashrama. Very few ashramas are there where convents are attached. Convents means nunnery, for nuns to stay, women being attached. In West it is common, in India it is not made because of the social acceptance is very little unless they are truly spiritual segment belong to. So, there she used to go, and then one of the convents attached to the ashrama, San Francisco, just like we have a women wing within the monastery itself, they have women wings. And all foreign centers are not actually the branches of Ramakrishna Math and Mission. They are all, because we cannot have a branch, legal branch in the foreign country. They don't, government laws are there. The local people will join and make a center. When Swamiji was there, Swamiji came. They are all centers made by local group of devotees in which our Swamis go and stay. Unofficially, it is a branch of the Ramakrishna Math and Mission, but officially, government has not yet given for me religious orders to have branches in other, say this one. The Swamis are appointed by the trust, those trusts, and there is payment also, salary, which will be, of course, they will credit back to the account as donation. So this is the, there they have the nunnery also. When she joined the mutt, she has written a letter to me because they were known to me through our Harinamanaji Maharaj. So please accept my loving, and means what will be their awareness when they take sannyasa, though she is almost brought up in Western culture. Amidst years she has stayed there. But the pure Hindu Indian awareness of renunciation, tyagada bhavane, aantarika bhavanegalu hegirutte anta. Please accept my loving and respectful pranams. This is dash 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 from Vedanta's convent of in San Francisco. Hope you and all residents of Bailur Math Ashrama are keeping well in all ways and are leading beautiful, inspired lives, being bathed in Mother and Sri Ramakrishna's benign grace, gentle touch, and constant guidance. See the words how they use. You are all well in all ways, in all probable ways, and leading a beautiful, inspired lives, being bathed in Mother and Sri Ramakrishna's benign grace. Grace. Gentle touch, Bhagavantana Sparsha, constant guidance. Swami wanted to share with you this auspicious news, that through Sri Ramakrishna's and Mother's grace, and through the grace of great teachers and all realized saintly souls and by the blessings of elders of the Belur Math, it has been proposed that we shall be given Brahmacharya vows as on auspicious occasion of Guru Purnima. One Swami will be initiating into Brahmacharya and another Swami will be repeating the vows. Swami, it is truly Mother's grace alone and blessings and support of loving teachers like you that has been carrying us all the way along. But we, as often little children do, forget that and like to play and think a little with our own minds. The Swamis have given us a copy of the vows from Belur Math. Interestingly, Swami, as we have long back I had read, just today I got it. As we read those, the opposite samskaras seem to build into whirlpool and take the mind for a ride. Brahmacharya Pratigna ಓದ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಆ ಒಳಗಿನ ಸಂಸ್ಕಾರಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಹಿಂದಿನ ಸಂಸ್ಕಾರಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಒಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಬಂದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಂಗೆ ಕಾಣುತ್ತೆ. ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ, ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವಿ ರೀಡ್ ದೋಸ್ ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಸಂಸ್ಕಾರಸ್ ಸೀಮ್ ಟು ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಅಪ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಪೂಲ್ ಸುಳಿ ನೀರಿನ ಸುಳಿಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ರೈಡ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಸಿನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಎಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಸಿಟ್ ಇನ್ ಮದರ್ಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಚ್ ಇಟ್. ಅದನ್ನು ಆ ಮನಸ್ಸು ಆಟ ಆಡೋದು ನೋಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ತಾಯಿ ಮಡಿಲಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಆ ನನ್ನ ಮನಸ್ಸೇ ಆ ಕಡೆ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಅವಳು ಸುಳಿ ಥರ ಎಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗೋದು ನನ್ನನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ಕೋಬಹುದು. ಆ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಚರ್ಯ ಪ್ರತಿಜ್ಞೆ ಓದ್ತಾ ಇರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಒಳಗಿನ ಸಂಸ್ಕಾರಗಳು ಹೇಗಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ. We have nothing to do but to pray to Mother and Sri Ramakrishna to guide our understanding and heart. Guide our understanding and heart for, yakandre, most of the time we feel so helpless being caught in the whirlpool. But our dear Mother gives the experience as if we are caught and as if we are helpless. Atai, ನಾನೆಲ್ಲ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಲೆಸ್ ಆಗಿರೋಂಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಆಗ್ತಾಯಿದೆ ಅಂತ ತೋರಿಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾಳೆ. ನಾವು ಆ ಸುಳಿಯೊಳಗೆ ಬಿದ್ದಂಗೆ ಮತ್ತು ನಾನು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಲೆಸ್ ಆಗಿರೋಂಗೆ ಆಗ್ತಾಯಿದೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಿಜ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಅಂತ ತೋರಿಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾಳೆ. ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಕಾಟೆಡ್, ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಲೆಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಶೀ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಎ ರೇ ಆಫ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಹೋಪ್ and grace to gently lift us up from that sauna. Aa sthitiyinda namge etkolakke one soft tender idu aashrayavanna alkodtaale. Swami, I do have the article that you shared with us in spring 2016 called Brahmacharya in Monastic Life, a detailed descriptive and immensely thought-provoking letter, rather a short manual that you had written to another monk. I cherish that and am so thankful to have received that, Swami. I shall go over again and am sure to receive much inspiration and power and spiritual solace from it. Thank you immensely for sharing that, Swami. Swami, please give your blessing on this auspicious event of our life making the beginning of another serious step in the spiritual journey. Adhyatmika yatrayalli prayanadalli innond important step thogota idini, serious step in spiritual journey. Please bless us that we will keep the vows for all time, and first and foremost of all, we will develop true love and devotion and dedication to Mother and Sri Ramakrishna, regardless of what the situation may be. ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಯಾವ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದರೂ ರಾಮಕೃಷ್ಣ ಶಾರದಾ ದೇವಿಯ ಚರಣಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನನ್ನ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಮತ್ತು ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣ ಸಮರ್ಪಣೆ ಇರಲಿ ಅಂತ. ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಮದರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗ್ರೇಷಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ರಿಮೈಂಡೆಡ್ ಮೀ ಸೆವರಲ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಏನಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ನನ್ ದಟ್ ಎ ನನ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಎನ್ ಒ ಎನ್ ಇ ಇನ್ ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಎ ನನ್. ನನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಎನ್ ಒ ಎನ್ ಇ ಝೀರೋ, ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಇರೋ ಹಾಗೆ ಆದರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ದಟ್ ಎ ನನ್ ಎನ್ ಯು ಎನ್ ನನ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇಡ್. ಹಾಂ, ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಇರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಹೋದಾಗ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಾನು ನಿಜವಾದ ಸನ್ಯಾಸಿನಿ ಆಗ್ತೀನಿ. ಮೇ ಹರ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೈರಿಂಗ್ ರಿಮೈಂಡರ್ಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಟ್ರೂ, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್. ಐ ಸಿನ್ಸಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಂಬ್ಲಿ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಟು ಕೈಂಡ್ಲಿ ಶವರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್ಸ್, ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಶಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಮದರ್. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ರಿಪ್ಲೈ ಒಂದು ಓದ್ತೀನಿ. ಡಿಯರ್ ಡಿವೈನ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಮ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ಯಾಲಿಟಿ, ಅಮೃತಸ್ಯ ಪುತ್ರಿ, ನಮಸ್ತೆ. ಹೇಲ್ ಅನ್ ಟು ಯು ಮೈ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್, ವೆಲ್ ಡನ್. ಮೈ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಫಿಲ್ಡ್ ಲವ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಯು. ನೌ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಡ್ ಎ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಆಫ್ ಗಾಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗಾಡೆಸಸ್, ದಿ ರಿಯಲ್ ಹೆವನ್ ಇನ್ ಡೀಡ್. ನೌ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಗ್ಲೋರಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಟರ್ನಲ್ ಬ್ಲಿಸ್, ಎವರ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಶಲ್ ಅಟೈನ್ ಆನ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಾಡಿಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಸನ್ಯಾಸದ ಮುಂಚೆನೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಮಠ ಸೇರಿದಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ಎರಡು ವಿಷಯ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಒಂದು ಆತ್ಮ ಸಂಯಮ, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಡಿಸಿಪ್ಲಿನ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಅಟೆಂಡ್ ದಿ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್. ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೇಯರಲ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ಲಾಗಲಿ ಬೇಲೂರು ಮಠದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗಲಿ ಯಾರನ್ನ ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫೆಲ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಕ್ರೈಮ್. ಅನ್ಲೆಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಟು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಯುವರ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯೂ, ಜಗತ್ತಿನ ಕಡೆ ನಿನ್ನ ದೃಷ್ಟಿಯನ್ನು ಪರಿವರ್ತನೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊ. ಜಗತ್ತು ಹೀಗೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಹೀಗೇ ಇತ್ತು, ನಿನ್ನೊಳಗೆ ಏನಿದೆಯೋ ಅದನ್ನು ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಜಗತ್ತನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ? ನಿನ್ನೊಳಗೆ ಏನು ದೋಷ ಇದೆಯೋ ಅದು ಬೇರೆಯವ್ರು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ? ಒಂದು ಮಗು ಎಲ್ಲೂ ನೋಡಲ್ಲ, ಒಬ್ಬ ಜ್ಞಾನಿ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ನೋಡಲ್ಲ, ನೀನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಯಾಕೆ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ? ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಸಿ ಡಿವೈನ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ವೇರ್, ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಸಿ ದಿ ಡಿವೈನ್ ವಿಲ್. ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೂ ಭಗವಂತ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಮಾರ್ಗದಿಂದ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ. ಪ್ರಕೃತಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವ್ರ ವಾಸನೆ ಅವರ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದೇರ್ ವಾಸನಾ ಸೈಮ್ ಶಿಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕನ್ನಡ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ಟು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಅವರ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯೂ, ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋದ್ರೂ ನಾವೇನಂದರೆ ಸಮೇ ಕನ್ನಡ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್, ದಟ್ ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಓವರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡನ್. ಸೊ ವೇರ್ ಎವರ್ ವಿ ಗೋ, ದ ಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸಿ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅಲೋನ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಟು ಹಂಸ. ಹಂಸ ಈಸ್ ಹಂಸ, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಗುಡ್. ದುರ್ಯೋಧನ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯುಧಿಷ್ಠಿರ ವರ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಟು, ಯುಧಿಷ್ಠಿರ ವಾಸ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಒನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದುರ್ಯೋಧನ ವಾಸ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಗುಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಬೋತ್ ಕಮ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಎನಿ, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋಬಡಿ ಗುಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಕಾಶಿ ದೇ ಗೋ, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ನೆವರ್ ಗೋ ಅಗೇನ್ ಟು ದಿ ಕಾಶಿ. so much of dirt everywhere, the way in which, only that you saw. And you could not see anything good. God was there. It is Kashi, golden Kashi. Saints and realized souls go there to enjoy that because they don't see the dirt. So, dirty mind sees dirt everywhere. Divine mind will see divine everywhere. There is nothing called dirty here because it has come, the whole universe has come out of God. And it is last after realization also you see everything divine, everywhere God. So these two, to change your world view, this is an imperative, it's something like an order for a monastic, one who lives in the ashrama. He has to see divine everywhere, in everyone, under all situations of life, circumstances, bodily conditions, everything. And then to have total self-control everywhere, while talking, while walking, everywhere, all fields of activities, to have self-control. May the Divine Mother Sharda Devi guide every step of your life on the greatest journey for the grandest conquest of nature, on the holy path to God. Sorry, Prakriti Anna. Now, when you exam pass, Madhvekadre, ishtu nartha idvi. Hedrukondo, oyo, yenu no kansale, ade paper barodo. Again, Canada. So, even at old age, ripe old age, he has gone for chemistry paper and physics paper has been given. Such how deep it goes, you see, to conquer the nature and go the journey to reach the transcendental realm. May she crown you with success. I sincerely wish and expect that some of the renunciates at least should strive intensely, dedicating their all to God and reach the summit to proclaim to the world, yes, I have touched the feet of God. See, a few at least will struggle intensely and realize God and tell, I have entered the realm of spirit where eternal bliss, eternal freedom exists and every human can attain it if he or she is ready to pay the price, and the price is renunciation of world and all earthly enjoyments and serving all beings with love, tyaga and seva. Tyaga and seva, this will definitely lead you to realize. And my dear child, I expect the same from you too. Do not divert your attention to the external situation you have to face in your day-to-day life. Be busy with your internal world. Every ashrama, the situations will be highly fluctuating. Because we are dealing with humans and living with humans. Don't divert your attention to the external situations you have to face in your day-to-day life. Be busy with your inner world. You have to learn and practice being independent of external situations and circumstances. It is but an art and an immediate necessity. Do you understand? Keep watch. Practicing to be independent of external situations and circumstances. Forget your past entirely. Break your identity entirely and with your old self, so much so that earlier person is dead and gone, never to be traced again in your consciousness, mind or memory. That with sannyasa, with entering monastery, with brahmacharya diksha and all that, the past person is dead and gone, not to turn back and see at all. You should not find that person. New life, new birth, new this one. derail yourself from the track you are till now traveling. In all Upanishads, he promises, till now I spent life like this. I was thinking, it is all what we saints usually say. I wasted all my life, I am running after the world. Now, the rest of the life I will spend for God. It is there in the Vedas, telling to God. Yesterday we saw, no? Brahadvadema, how I spent my days, and now I will Duruktan. Pushing aside Brahadvadema. So many times it comes in the Vedas. Derail yourself from the track you are till now traveling. Let your thoughts be divine. Talk and walk be divine. Very difficult. Unknowingly and only comment comes out. The comment will make me go to hell. I don't understand at all. Purindra Dasa, in one song he says, Avana bayuve eke avanyaro neenyaro avana papake neenu bhagiyade. He is doing something is happening in the world. Why do you comment upon it? Why do you criticize? You have become the shareholders of his sin. I have absorbed. Even if I see, I need not take it inside. I take it and tell it again. It has settled down in my consciousness. One day I will be that person, in one life or the other. Telling, seeing, whatever you think, whatever you tell, you will ultimately become that. Let your thoughts be divine, talk and walk be divine, your behavior and dealings be divine. Be divine yourself, feel divinity within yourself and all around. Let not a trace of worldliness be in you at any time. That Christ, they wanted to, one person who has done some adultery, the whole group decides he must be, by stone pelting, he must be killed. By stone pelting, he must be killed. Then Christ will be come there or something, I don't remember, I don't know. Happened to... Yes, Maharaj?
One woman. One woman commits He says that whoever does not commit any sin, he can...
Christ says, no? Christ will be there or he comes...
He is there in the...
So... When the decision is taken by the crowd that she will be killed by pelting the stones, he says, one who has not committed sin, let him throw the first stone. What? I've been doing all this life, the same thing. And now I am seeing there, I am taking a decision. Let not even a trace of worldliness be in you at any time. Difficulties, problems, constrained situations. See what all we face in monastery. Difficulties, problems, constrained situations, unfavorable conditions appear time and again. Face them boldly. Never get disheartened or dejected, despondent or depressed. Be cheerful always, in joy and in suffering. Be cheerful, in joy is all right. In suffering, be cheerful. See, this is life of a monk. Know and feel always, because you are going to objectify everything away from you, objectification. Suffering is objectified and you are the Atman, subject. Know and feel always, God is with you. Joys and sorrows, pains and shocks of life are teachers and great friends. Welcome them. Joys and sorrows, pains and shocks, insults, all these things that we see in our lives, they are necessity for us. The situation is created for my sake. Everything is opposite. Why this is happening like this? Because you are there. All this is happening only for your sake. The moment you change, the whole thing changes. Joys and sorrows, pains and shocks of life are our teachers and great friends. Learn to be with God always. Be ever fearless. This is one of the important emphasis of Swamiji. Be fearless. I am fearless, I can do anything. Being humble, being everything, giving yourself totally to God, because God is behind you, God is within you, God is with you. Fearless is not because I am fearless, but my Master is all capable. Peep within yourself and see you are Purna, complete, wholesome. You lack nothing. All the enjoyments of this world are but a speck compared to the ocean of bliss within you. ಹೊರಗಡೆಯವರು ಎಲ್ಲ ಜಗತ್ತಿನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆನಂದಗಳು ಸೇರಿಸಿದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಕಣ ಮಾತ್ರ ನೀನು ಒಳಗಡೆ ಇರೋ ಆನಂದದ ಸಾಗರವನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದಾಗ. ಗಾರ್ಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆಲ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಂಟೈಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಎಂಟೈಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಕೀಪ್ ದಿ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಪ್ಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಟ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ಟೇಷನ್ಸ್. Maya, the great deluding power, is all powerful. She has deluded every jiva, imprisoning them in the cage of the body. Body is your wrapper, a mere sheet. Do not identify with it. Take refuge at the feet of the Almighty, who is the Lord of that Maya. Mama Maya Duratyaya. Mamevaye prapadyante. Surrender. And you are safe. Be pure, my child. Be pure. Then, purity is the only security in this world of mortals. Important statement. Purity is the only security in this world of mortals. Tap out your purity of the Atman to pervade the entire being of yours at all levels, physical, mental, emotional, intellectual, and also in the dealings and relationships with this world. Tap out the purity, pervade the whole being. Purity is to live in God as God. One capital, one small letter. Purity is to live in God, G capital, as God, G small letter. In Indian context, it is called Brahmacharya. It gives us freedom from lust and carnality, from the animalhood that is innate in all beings. Generally, Brahmacharya implies practice of celibacy and cessation of all types of sexual indulgences, including looking at a woman as woman and looking at a man as man and oneself as man or woman. Hindu scriptures, one hengsan hengsag nododu, gansan gansag nododu, nannanna gandu hendu anta artha madkolodu. ಆ ಒಂದು ಭಾವನೆಯನ್ನು ತೆಗೆದುಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಚರ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು. All religions of the world have denounced carnality, lower passions and base instincts. Hindu dharma matra alla, ella dharmagalallo idide. The main intention is to awaken spirit within. Adu legitimate enjoyments are not permitted, are not sin. ಅದು ಪಾಪ ಕಾರ್ಯವಲ್ಲ, ಆದರೆ ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನವನ್ನು ಕೊಡಲ್ಲ. ಶರೀರವಾಗಿಯೇ ಇದ್ದು ಶರೀರವಾಗಿಯೇ ಸಾಯ್ತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಗೃಹಸ್ಥ ಲೈಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಸಿನ್ ಇಫ್ ಈ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಎ ಪ್ರೋಜನಿ, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಲೋ ಹಿಮ್ ಟು ಅಟೈನ್ ಗಾಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈ ಇಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಬಾಡಿಲಿ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಈ ಇಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಓನ್ಲಿ. He is not Atman. He cannot find out God. Essentially, Brahmacharya means dwelling and moving in God, as fish moves in and moves about in water. Neerali, meenugalu odaadadange Bhagavantanalli odaadodakke Brahmacharya antare. Brahmani charati moves in God. My humble request to you, my child, never waste a single moment of your life. Every type of loss can be compensated, but lost time can never be brought back. Be vigilant. Consciously offer every moment of your life to God, every breath of your life, every heartbeat, every thought that passes through your mind, every action and feeling of yours be an oblation to the divine. Oblation Rahuti. Take up spiritual life seriously. Seriously means not to pay attention to the external factors which do not deserve our attention, and those that are based on falsehood, those that are unimportant and can be avoided. To be serious means, pay serious attention to your spiritual practice. Serious means what? Not to pay attention to external factors which do not deserve our attention. Again, the mind goes there. What is it doing? You are no business. Do not deserve. It doesn't deserve your attention. You are wasting time. Those that are based on falsehood. That's why if somebody doesn't give me some information, I feel happy. I don't need it. There are people who need that information and they have to act. I don't need. If they don't give you information, somebody is coming, some date, they don't tell me, doesn't matter. I am happy about it. Nanu matra helila. That how it comes, if it is necessary for you, only I alone don't know, everybody has told. Everybody knows, I don't know. I wonder, if it is needed, from somewhere God will bring that information. See, sometimes this, when some important thing, I was in Ekanta, in a place where I myself never came out of for almost 1 year. What is that place? Mir. At that time, one day when some devotee had brought some plantain and given. It was wrapped in a newspaper. In that newspaper, an important message for my sadhana was there. How, if you need anything, God will provide it somehow or other, it will reach you. Many times it happens. Whatever you need, somewhere. Don't load yourself with unwanted things. And unimportant, falsehood, unimportant and can be avoided. Be indifferent to the praises and blames, gossips on you and blasphemy. Blasphemy means ninde, ninda. ಜನರು ಏನೇನು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ಡೋಂಟ್ ಬಾದರ್. ಡೋಂಟ್ ಬಾದರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕೇರ್ ಅಂತ, ನಾಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಈಗೋ. ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಸ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕೇರ್, ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕೇರ್, ನೋ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕರ್ಸಸ್, ಶ್ರಾಪ ಶುಡ್ ನೆವರ್ ಕಮ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೌತ್. ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಎ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ವಿಲ್, it is something which is to be totally discarded and disclaimed. Shaap dena, dusre ko bura hone ke liye ichha karna, to think of somebody's, we have to always think of the welfare. Even if somebody is doing something bad, we can go and pray for them. Thakur, give them good mind, good way of living. He has done, I will do. No. That tit for tat, tat for tit will go on. Community life is where you practice being independent of external situation. Community life, where people live together. Community life, like a monastery, ashramas. Life, where you practice to being independent of external situation. Situation will be always adverse because your evolution needs it. Nimma krama vikasakke ಉಲ್ಟಾ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿಯಲ್ಲೇ ಬೆಳೆಯೋದು. ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಯು ಗ್ರೋ, ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಯು ಗ್ರೋ, ದಿ ಸಿಚುಯೇಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೋರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್. ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ರೆಸ್ಲಿಂಗ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗಿವನ್ ಎ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್. ಒನ್ ಶಾಟ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಫಾಲ್ ಡೌನ್ because he is master. That person gets confidence. Oh, I have made the master to fall down today. Then master, after awakening his self-confidence, then he will show, little by little, little. Then he will leave. He will equals. Then he grows a little more stronger, he will leave. Little more stronger. As you grow, the opponent will be still stronger. Then you will see. That is the way to teach and grow. Nature is teaching like that. This situation will go away, I will be happy. No. You will be put into the mixer, Sadhan Bhaiya's mixer. Where you practice to be independent of situations.
We went to one song, you told Ramakrishna Mission, not Ramakrishna Mission, Ego Fishing Mission.
It is a field where you cultivate forbearance, humility, to give love, concern and compassion, even to those who inflict pain upon you, total dependence on God at all times, pure love of God, wherein you have given yourself entirely and unconditionally to Him. Thakur Sri Ramakrishna is giving you various experiences, some good, some bad, some painful, some pleasurable, some delightful. He is training you for a higher life. You have to go beyond good and bad, purity and impurity, pain and pleasure, joys and sorrows, happiness and misery, favorable and unfavorable. conditions, hopes and despondency. And that is verily sannyasa. To go beyond all dualities and pour your love on all without seeing merits and demerits of the people. See what is sannyasa, where it comes. And always we think, Sulpa Bhagadri, no Sulpa Bhagastarenta. Usual tendency to think is, if you bend a little, they will make you bend more. They will trample on you. No. They will change. All saints' life, all avatars' life, you will see exactly opposite happening. Because it happens, if you bend down a little, they will make you bend down and trample on you only if you have worldly ideals. Because you go on competition in the world. Here, no. Here, when you go, become humble and humble in the spiritual world, more and more acceptance comes. More and more acceptance comes. If you are sincere to God from the core, you will be, Balnanaji used to tell us, true spirituality will be universally accepted. Be a true spiritual aspirant. True spirituality is universally accepted. There will be test. There will be training, correction. See, Shankaracharya, after all realization, he is preaching and having number of disciples, then the chandala comes, Apasara, Apasara. We will Apasara. Yes, chandala. Yes, yes. Sri Ramakrishna used to tell, as long as I am alive, so long I learn. Training never ends. To make the perfected little more perfection, nature is ever ready. In Bengal they say, Purbe Shadu, Urbe Chai, Marbe Shadu, Urbe Chai, Tobe Shadur Gun Gai. To praise a sadhu, morbe sadhu, when he dies, even then you should not praise him. Urbe chai, he will become ash, and then when ash starts flying away, then only you can sing his glory. Means, the kshurasya dhara nishita duratyaya durgav padantat kavayo vadanti. The path is so serious, any time, any fall can be there. Be aware, beware, and hold on to God at all times. Be extremely humble. And verily, sannyasa, to go beyond all dualities and pour your love on all beings without seeing merits and demerits. And that is the sainthood too. Dive within yourself and discover the eternal, immutable ocean of bliss that you are. Ananda Swarupa. See within yourself. Simultaneously, you will have to practice pure love of God, self-surrender, so that you will be released from the external bonds, freeing you to enter within, to discover yourself and meet your eternal beloved there. To turn inward and go, self-surrender, pure love of God, so that you will be released from this world to go and enter inside. Do not waste your time in fighting with this world. It's a shadow, shadow fighting, which kills time, leaves you empty. Be ever in the company of God and His true devotees. The inner channels linking to the divine should never be disconnected. Inner channels to God, as if you are anchored in God, you will be fearless and you will find great peace within. Instead of turning within, if you turn outside, then your life will become miserable. You can't find peace. For every problem, run at once to God, to Sri Ramakrishna and Holy Mother. Even for secular problems, we have to find spiritual solution so that we transcend the sphere of problems once for all. Laukika problems ke samasyegalige aadhyatmika samadhanavanne hudukbeku yavaglu. Yakandre adu shashvatavagi problems solve agutte. Otherwise, you'll be jumping from one problem to another problem. That's all. Perhaps bigger problem. So, if you try this problem will be over, another four problems will come up. If you try to solve in the worldly way, all people do. Otherwise, we will be leaping from problem to problem without finding any solution. Life is short. Make best use of it. Leaving the world to itself, be in your own joy like a 5-year-old girl. This is Thakur saying, whenever you happen to come to India, please visit our ashrama. Welcome. I shall give you, it shall give us. Divine contentment and unearthly joy to meet you and be with you. We need physical, mental, emotional well-being. Physical, mental, emotional well-being. And it should be through spiritual culture, spiritual evolution alone. Then it will be holistic, paripurna, complete, everlasting. The shrines attached to monasteries and convents or the nunneries are not places of prayer, worship, meditation, but mainly they are highly energized spots where renunciates, devotees and general people can transform their lives in an essential way and undergo internal transformation which eventually leads to realization. It is an important point to note. In the monasteries, the temples that we have is not an ordinary temples or ordinary prayer halls that we find. These are centers where the transformation, internal transformation is going to take place. I will read again. The shrines attached to monasteries, convents, that's why we see the moment you see a temple, whether it is a religious temple or a monastic temple, you will know by the stones they put around, Bhuta stones. The temple suttu Bhuta kallidre, it's a religious temple. Monastery, Matadali temple ge, Bhutat kalliralla. Bhutat. So we will not have, we need not please the Bhutaganas. Because the ganas don't have a right. Shiva ganas, suppose.
Dvajastambha, Tulsi, something.
Dvajastambha will be there. Dvajastambha will be there. Ganapatarasanati. Daily they have to put. Because the Shiva ganas, a bhakta can go and sit on the lap of Shiva. Gana cannot go and sit. Though ganas are there all around with them, But he must take a special permission from Parvati. Amma amma van sati eli amma appan ge nan karkondage. So, because they are ganas. Because they are ganas. They want to be subjects of God. Subject to God. They don't want to be, I am servant of God. I want to be servant of God. Servant cannot go and sit on the simhasana. And God can call him and make him sit. Come today. You be with me. He can, but he cannot go and sit on the simhasana. But a bhakta can slowly go and sit on his lap itself, not on the simhasana. So these are not only the places of prayer. Prayer will go on, worship will go on, meditation. They are not only the places of prayer, worship and meditation, but mainly highly energized spots. They are energized spots where renunciates, tyagigalu, devotees and general people can transform their life in an essential way and undergo internal transformation which eventually leads to realization. Make full use of this rare opportunity of living in a convent. You fully utilize Madhukanta. I used not to allow that girl to sleep during nights last one and a half months was that glorious days of her, this one. Not allowing anybody to talk non-spiritual matters. And night till 2 o'clock she will not allow. Go on singing the bhajan. So I will sing one bhajan, you sing one bhajan. You have come to monastery for sleeping, is it? And Radha Bhai will go on sitting outside. At 2 o'clock he will go and sleep in his room. After she sleep, may the mother allows her to sleep. Utilize maximum utility. You have to make full use of this rare opportunity of living in a convent. Convent means monastery for women. Wherever you are, in a shrine, be fully conscious of Thakur's and Mother's living presence. There and with one-pointed attention, attend to the practices. Fully you must feel the presence of God there and attend to the practices. Celebrate the death of your past. Celebrate the death of your past. Your entire past and dawn of a new era in your life. A joyful journey to the Absolute. Let every day shine with new, fresh, renewed enthusiasm for the spiritual attainment and transcendence of nature. Take regular physical exercises, preferably yoga exercises or whatever suits a woman's body. Be punctual in meditation. Spend more time in intense prayer silently without allowing others to know. Prayer can go on during work and activities. And at all other times, through prayer, we will be in direct presence of God. Prayer invokes God's instant presence. Observe joyfully silence. Let your mind be filled with God and be it free from world-related inner dialogues. Let your heart find delight in His inner divine presence and your face radiate joy and blessings. be a blessing to yourself and to others. Yes, shall we stop today? I wanted to take Trisuparna mantra, but when going with text, once in a way, this one. Om Niranjanam Nityam Anantarupam Bhaktanukampadhrita Vikraham Vai Ishavataram Parameshamidyam Tam Ramakrishnam Shirasanamamaha.